Every year, there are many new immigrants to Canada, a large number of whom do not speak English as a first language. This video series is designed to help English language learners practice listening, speaking, reading, and writing in English. This video will focus on listening and speaking in English. You will hear from other immigrants, some of whom are new to Canada. You will also have the chance to practice your own listening and speaking skills in English. Before we begin, let's take a look at some key words you need to know. Difficult, not easy, requiring great physical or mental effort. Example, learning English can be difficult. Opportunity, a chance for progress and improvement. Example, I have the opportunity to practice my English at school. Practice, to learn by repetition, doing something over and over again to get good at it. Example, I practice playing the guitar so that I can play well. Volunteer, a person who spends time helping others with a charity or organization and does not get paid for it. Immigrant Youth Center, a place for immigrant youth to go and hang out, get support, make friends, and have fun. Youth worker, a person that works with young people or youth at a youth center. Example, Amir is a youth worker at the Immigrant Youth Center. Status, a person or country's position or current situation within society and the world. Examples, a newcomer to Canada has an immigrant status. The political status in a country at war is usually unstable. Formally, following an agreed or official way of doing something. Example, I learned grammar formally in the classroom, and I learned to speak English informally by speaking to my friends at lunch. Meet Amir. Amir immigrated to Canada when he was young, and now he works for the Immigrant Youth Centre in Markham, Ontario. He began his time at the Immigrant Youth Centre volunteering as a mural artist. This led to a full-time position as a youth worker.
Salam, halashama, ismi man has Amir Akbari. My name is Amir Akbari. I came to Canada about 20 years ago when I was 5 years old. We moved to Canada from Iran, a country in the Middle East. The reason that me and my family came to Canada, well, there was many reasons for it. One was the political status of Iran at the time. A war had just finished between Iran and Iraq. But most of all, I think for my parents, the most important thing was to give their children, us, a better opportunity in a country that was economically and socially at a better state at the time. So it was mostly for us to come and get our education and to have brighter futures. I think if I had to choose one part of English that was most difficult for me, it would have to be the grammar aspect of it, because I'd never formally taken lessons. So reading and writing and speaking as for a young child, it was relatively easy and I was able to pick it up. But learning all the technicals about grammar was a bit more difficult, and that took more time and more practice.
We would now like to give you time to practice speaking and listening in English. Discuss the following question with a partner. Take turns talking, listening, and taking notes. Nod your head as you listen to your partner to show that you understand what they are telling you. Ask your partner, what part of learning English do you find most difficult and why? Speaking, listening, writing and grammar, reading. You may begin discussing your answers while your partner takes notes, then switch and you take notes while your partner discusses. Learning English can be difficult, but here are some suggestions to help you learn. Study vocabulary and focus on the meaning of the words. Keep a word notebook by making your own personal dictionary of English words. Take every opportunity to hear and use English. The more you practice, the better. Example, watch movies, speak English with friends, read English books, and say the words out loud. Before we continue, let's take a look at some more key terms and what they mean in English. Community. A group of people living in a particular